Welcome back to Leaders of Tomorrow. From the times of the Nizam, there's one name that's almost synonymous with Hyderabad itself. And in fact, this company was one of the first retailers of pearls.
Welcome back to Leaders of Tomorrow. Ludhiana is often considered that land of entrepreneurship. It is the land of opportunity for a number of industry veterans and new businesses alike. And therein lies the story of Young Man Woolen Mill, a third generation family run business that is aiming to achieve greater heights both in India and globally.
तब मोती का व्यापार गद्दी पे बैठकर था, गद्दी पे भी बैठकर एक एक मोती
यंग एट हार्ट एंड इन देयर डिजाइन बट विद अ मैच्योर हिस्ट्री बिहाइंड देम. The family owned Young Man Woolen Mills of Ludhiana has been a trendsetter in the textile space since the early 50s. It was one of the few companies out of India that was exporting to foreign markets such as Russia and Europe even in the late 80s.
Importing the best quality of seawater as well.
But
as
the early 90s saw the collapse of USSR,
like China, Japan,
which meant a crippling blow to Young Man export business.
After disintegration
sort and grade them according
that
to quality
market also
and then
collapsed
spread them
due
into
to
attractive strength and other
depreciation of their currency.
The when I joined the business, we were really in bad shape. We had a big separation in the company. So due to that, we had a major setback.
A major strategic overhaul was the need of the hour. Young Man did so by diversifying into a new area, that of mink blankets. It was a refreshing change for this traditional company, one that is paying off rich dividends for the Jagotas.
Because of that revolution, that what we have changed in that time,
we diversified. Now they have been changed to this mink blanket only.
We have actually spent a lot of time
my dream.
In.
Well, over the past years, Young Man has really focused into the market and come closer to the customer, which has really helped us in having a strong position in the market. Currently, I would say we are one of the largest manufacturers of blankets and the fabrics which we are doing in India. This has really moved us forward against our competitors.
What left the competition sweating was Young Man's renewed focus on the domestic market, more than it had ever done during its export-oriented path. A nationwide distribution network has enabled Young Man to garner almost 85% of its 120 crore revenue from the domestic market alone, bringing the company ever closer to the Indian customer and his needs, and thus resulting in its superior market position.
We have a very good setup in the domestic market where we have about 300 plus dealers and about 30 or 40
and
agents.
It is this trust of
and
quality that
those are for the blanket division. And we have two, three more divisions like fabrics and comforters, which is distributed in their own ways. And not to forget the defense market, which we also face in.
The Jagotas have ensured that their family's business legacy has been brought forward to inspire the company to even greater heights. The constant adherence to the tradition of creativity, which, imbued with a contemporary focus on research and a market-driven philosophy, has greatly augmented Young Man's customer base, increasing both its appeal and penetration in the market.
I think 12 years back also, and it's intact.
Well, Young Man always believed in getting the data from the market, and this we have learned from the international companies who used to come here and get the data of our companies, how many machines installed and all those stuff. So I used to think, you know, what does it help? And it has actually helped us in getting all the population and the purchasing power of all the states which we are selling, and according to that data we really see make a strategy as to how many dealers we've got to appoint and how many distributors we've got to appoint, so that there's no cross cutting. Eventually it helps them to grow, and at the end of the day the company grows like that.
With Young Man's focus on high quality, modern designs that are easy on the customer's pocket is winning it new customers every day. And this is not limited to India alone. A growing belief in their quality has led Young Man to roll out another geographical expansion plan, one that has seen them grow despite the rough tides of global recession.
We always think recession as an opportunity. In recession times, we have been inventing a lot of products, and according to all the purchasing power of the people, it helped us in creating a variety, and through that we went forward through the recession period.
Young man now has a burgeoning presence in European countries like UK, as well as Australia, New Zealand, Middle East, USA and Canada. It has recently added another unit in Himachal Pradesh to tackle the increasing scale of its operations. And the role of its R&D has been paramount in achieving that expansion.
Our R&D center actually at Young Man has been really strong. So we keep on developing new products, which helps us to grow further and grasp the market.
Young Man counts adaptability, innovation and technology as its core USP, and its integrated manufacturing unit with the latest knitting, dyeing, cutting and processing facilities more than proves its technological and innovative prowess.
We adapt very fast according to market conditions, innovate the product very fast, and the technology which we are using here in our company is the best in the world. I mean, it has really helped us to lead in the markets where we are selling.
With a growth strategy that envisages a constant upgradation of technology coupled with the regular upscaling of operations, this is one well-knit success story that shows no signs of unraveling anytime soon. Well, that was Ludhiana-based Young Man Woolen Mills capturing clients in India and abroad. On Leaders of Tomorrow, we'll continue to bring you stories of success and enterprise. In fact, you too could be featured on the show. To register yourself, just log on to www.leaders.economictimes.com or you can write in to us at leaders@economictimes.com. You could also call us on 0124-3058-100 or SMS leaders to 58888 and we'll get in touch with you. So until next week, goodbye and thanks for watching.
Brought to you by IndiaMart. More buyers, more suppliers, more business.